There are many design considerations for high cell count applications when it comes to battery gauging and protection. I will cover the gauging plus monitor and protector solutions from Texas Instruments. So the next question is, what can I do with a gauge? With the BQ769X0 family of monitors, there is a companion CEDV gauge available called the BQ78350-R1. This gauge provides an estimate of the remaining charge in the battery during use and can be tuned for the type of load, how the information is displayed and reported, and for the operating environment. The gauge also provides an estimate of the charge in the battery during charging. Some gauges are able to provide information about the state of health as well as record critical use information called lifetime data, as well as be a black box recorder to inspect what happened during a permanent fail event. Not all gauges behave the same or have the same features, and like the protectors and monitors, TI provides several different solutions for gauging high cell count applications. Before I get into the specifics of the high cell count gauging solutions, allow me to briefly cover the difference between the two gauging algorithms from TI. Compensated end of discharge voltage, or CEDV, is one algorithm. Impedance track, or IT, is the second algorithm. Each has benefits and constraints, so a little background may be useful. CEDV uses current integration for gauging. The gauge has accurate information about the amount of energy into and out of the battery. The CEDV algorithm calculates the 7% and 3% remaining state of charge values in real time based on load and temperature. This way, the user is alerted prior to the battery reaching zero. There is a complex formula that takes into account self-discharge and temperature effects. This method, of course, relies on learning full charge capacity by discharging the battery below 7% at least occasionally, which is one constraint of CEDV gauges. Since temperature and self-discharge current also impact the amount of available energy in the pack, the model needs to account for these variables as well. Here you can see the calculated 7% value under different discharge currents, with one curve shown in pink and the other in blue. The model uses the present state of charge, current, and temperature to estimate the state of charge equals 7% value under these different conditions. There are seven key parameters that affect the performance of the CEDV gauge. These parameters are defined by modeling the cell over two different current levels and three different temperatures. We can only measure the actual battery voltage curve shown here. Parameters EMF and C0 define the function to calculate the open circuit voltage using the existing state of charge and temperature. Parameters R0, R1, and T0 define the cell resistance based on the state of charge and temperature. R1 defines the slope of the resistance based on the state of charge, R0 the magnitude of the resistance, and T0 the slope of resistance dependent upon temperature. Parameter TC defines additional resistance increase at temperatures below 21 degrees C. Parameter C1 allows us to shift the whole function to the left. In this case, EDV2 is reached earlier, and so reserve capacity is provided. One unit of C1 shifts the function by about 0.39%. In summary, the CEDV gauge takes current integration and seven constants that describe the battery and system behavior to provide an estimate of the state of charge for the battery pack. Characterizing the cell for CEDV as well as requiring periodic full charge discharge cycles are requirements for accurate gauging with a CEDV gauge. Also, the aging of the battery is only approximated and is estimated by compensating the cell resistance based on cycle count. Now let's look at an impedance track gauge and see how it is different. The CEDV gauge utilizes Coulomb counting, which does not account directly for cell impedance changes during aging, self-discharge, and must have full-to-empty learning cycles, must develop a cell model with every cell maker, and although charge entering and leaving is measured, the total energy is still dependent on a complex model which becomes less accurate with cell aging. Impedance track directly measures the effect of discharge rate, temp, age, and other factors by learning cell impedance. This allows a calculation of the remaining capacity and full charge capacity, which changes as the battery changes. Before going into impedance track too much, let's review some of the terms for gauging. The open circuit voltage is the voltage that the cell will reach when completely relaxed with no load or charge. The depth of discharge is an indicator for how empty the system is and does not depend on load or temperature of the system. The remaining capacity is the usable capacity of the battery from the present depth of discharge to empty. The full charge capacity is the usable capacity from full to empty. This is different than design capacity, which is the capacity of the cell datasheet. The full charge capacity is dynamic and learned over time. The state of charge is what most people expect to see on the device, and shows the remaining capacity divided by the full charge capacity, giving a percent value. The open circuit profile of cells is fairly consistent if the cells are made the same way. Here is data showing the discharge curve for 5 different manufacturers. Most of the voltage measurements are within 5 millivolts of each other. Since the open circuit voltage database can be used with different manufacturers, a generic database allows significant simplification of fuel gauge implementation at the user side. These cell profiles are called Chem IDs by TI, and they are available through our gauge tools. Also, you can use a tool called GP Chem in order to create your own. Click on the link provided to see a tutorial on how to use the tool to match your cell with a TI database of cell. The impedance track algorithm uses the Chem ID as a starting point for the resistance table, and the table is updated during charge and discharge cycles. The gauge needs to complete at least one full learning cycle prior to shipping to have the most accurate gauging at the start of customer use. During the discharge cycle, the resistance table, RA table, is updated and stored in RAM. This table is then used to better predict the state of charge. The updating process happens naturally during the use of the product and reflects the actual parameters of the cell during the life of its use. So now let's look at a few high cell count gauge approaches. The first is a gauge with a monitor for each cell. This can be done with the BQ78350-R1 as the CEDV gauge and the BQ769X0 devices for the monitor protector for up to 5S, 10S, or 15S applications. The second approach is a top-of-stack gauge where the individual cells are not monitored by the gauge. A protector is usually used with this approach. The BQ34Z100-G1 is the impedance track version of this architecture, and the BQ34110 is the CEDV version. If you need a fully integrated gauge with individual cell monitoring and primary protection as well as gauging, then the BQ40Z50 or BQ40Z80 is the right approach. These gauges improve the accuracy of the gauging, reduce the size, and provide flexibility in protection and performance. The BQ78350-R1 is the companion fuel gauge for the BQ769X0 family of monitors that we have previously discussed. This is a CEDV-based gauge that supports high cell count and high current battery packs. The algorithm is completely self-contained and does not require a separate MCU to run any firmware. The monitor provides all the voltage and current information required to execute the CEDV algorithm with a simple two-chip solution that is scalable from 3S to 15S. This gauge supports batteries up to 320 amp hours with charge-discharge currents up to 320 amps. Lifetime data logging of critical parameters, state of health indication, and support for LCD or LED display. We haven't discussed authentication, which is a whole other presentation, but this gauge also supports SHA-1 authentication to enable the creation of battery packs that can only be used with specific end equipment. This is important for some applications where the entire system needs to be guaranteed safe and compatible, such as e-bikes, e-scooters, hoverboards, etc. The BQ769X0 monitors have the internal ADCs to monitor the cell voltage, die temperature, external thermistor, and pack current. The interface to the companion BQ78350-R1 is digital, so the system is less prone to error due to a noisy environment. All the devices in the family have the same features, so the design is easily scaled from the BQ76920 for 3 to 5S systems up to the BQ76940 for up to 15S systems. Now let's take a look at the top of stack gauges in more detail. The BQ34110 is a top-of-stack gauge that uses the CEDV algorithm. It only monitors the highest voltage in the pack, divided down and presented to the ADC, and also has a second ADC as a dedicated Coulomb counter for current integration. One of the unique features about the BQ34110 is the end-of-service state of health determination for rarely discharged applications, such as battery backup applications. For these systems, they do not go through the typical charge-discharge cycles that allow the gauge to determine the state of health of the battery. In this case, there is a very small adjustable discharge level that allows the gauge to determine if the state of health of the battery has degraded during its use to a point where it cannot guarantee the delivery of the rated power for the rated duration. For example, a battery backup system may guarantee a certain power for 100 seconds, and when the system is no longer able to deliver that, the BQ34110 will indicate this information to the host. The BQ34110 can be used in conjunction with monitors or protectors as needed to meet the safety and compliance standards for these applications. The BQ34Z100-G1 is the impedance track version of the top-of-stack gauge and has the added accuracy benefits that impedance track provides. Impedance track is specifically useful for LFP or lithium iron phosphate battery packs, as these have a very flat OCV curve. The IT algorithm takes this into account during the resistance table updates, which provides a high accuracy for LFP battery packs. And finally, let's take a look at the fully integrated gauges. The BQ40Z50 is a fully integrated gauge for up to 4S battery packs. It uses the latest impedance track algorithm and is available in a small 4mm by 4mm QFN package. This device is the workhorse for most notebook battery packs, and we are about to release the BQ40Z50-R3, which has updates to some of the key features of this device. The BQ40Z50-R3 is a firmware-only release and can be flashed onto existing BQ40Z50-R2 hardware. One of the features unique to the BQ40Z50 is the support of turbo mode, also known as Intel Dynamic Battery Power Technology, or DBPT. The BQ40Z50-R2 supports DBPT version 2, and the BQ40Z50-R3 supports DBPT version 3. This algorithm calculates a 10-second sustained peak power and current, as well as a 10-millisecond max peak power and current. This allows the system to know what power levels it can achieve without hitting critical voltages at the cell level, pack level, and system level, and can be tuned to individual systems. This gauge family is full-featured with comprehensive protection for multi-cell safety and is compatible with second-level protectors. The BQ40Z80 is similar to the BQ40Z50, but has expanded capabilities to support from 2S to 7S battery packs, keeping the same small 32-pin 4x4 thin QFN package. This part will support higher cell count applications like cordless vacuums, vacuum robots, drones, portable robotics, and battery backup systems. A future version will incorporate the end-of-service indication for rarely discharged applications. The BQ40Z80 brings some unique features that help it be more configurable for industrial applications. This chart shows all the new features built on top of the BQ40Z50 base functionality. Because the BQ40Z80 is scaled up to 7S, it naturally makes sense that high current packs will also be developed with this part. The device can natively support pack capacities up to 29 amp hour and battery currents up to 32 amps. With current scaling, the scale factor can be set between 0 and 100 with the scale current still in 1 milliamp resolution. To reduce losses in the sense resistor, a 1 milliohm typical sense resistor is supported, but this can be smaller if large currents are used. The BQ40Z80 has several multifunction pins that can be configured based on the specific application needs. Most unused pins can be configured as GPIOs with the capability of generating interrupts on pins through a flag mapping function. The flags may be ORed or ANDed together to trigger an interrupt on a particular GPIO pin, with up to 8 different flags ORed onto a single pin. Other multifunction pin functions are additional ADC inputs to monitor voltages or temperatures, a dedicated display pin to turn on the LEDs, and a presence pin to use for removable battery applications to assist in battery detection and entering and exiting lower power states. A new feature is a pre-discharge pin, which is useful when the load is highly capacitive, such as a motor. The pre-discharge pin allows charging up the cap until a predetermined voltage is reached, and then turning on the discharge FET. This reduces the chance of having the battery OCD and SCD protections trip when turning on the load, as it effectively soft starts the load and reduces the current spike. The BQ40Z80 also improves the authentication capabilities with elliptic curve cryptography, or ECC, as the encryption method for authentication. If you'd like to see more about the BQ40Z80, make sure to see the presentation on the BQ40Z80 in the deep dive, where I go into specific problems that can be solved with this device. That sums up the design considerations for high cell count applications. I hope I've given you things to consider when designing your battery pack and protection for your system, as well as a few devices from TI that can help you meet your design goals.